Hello friends, welcome to the world of Python. I am Preeti here. Today we are going to see the overview and its features of Python. Let's get started. Python is one of the most dynamic and versatile programming language. Since its inception in the year 1990, Python has become hugely popular, and even today, many of the programmers are using this Python as one of their programming language. Okay, so Python, we can say it is a general purpose, interactive, object oriented and high level language. It is a general purpose language. So we can say that Python is a general purpose language, so which can be used for all applications. And it is interactive language where you can get your result immediately. So it is interactive. It is an object oriented language where it is based on made up of classes and objects. You can also involve classes and objects in your program. So it is object oriented and high level programming language. Okay. It was first developed by Guido van Rossum in the year 1990. So this language was developed by Guido van Rossum in the early 1990. Python runs on any Unix variant, on the Mac or Windows or any other version. Okay. Next, we will see why it is called Python. When he began implementing this Python, Guido van Rossum, he was reading the published script, that the name of the script is Monty Python's Flying Circus, which was published in a BBC comedy show in 1970. So van Rossum, he needed a name for this programming language. So he thought that why can't we name this language to be Python, which is very short and unique and slightly mysterious also. That's why he called this language to be the Python. Coming to the history of Python, Guido van Rossum implemented Python in December 1989 at CWI Netherlands. This was a successor of ABC programming language. Okay, on October 16, 2000, Python 2.0 version was released with many new features. And in December 3, 2008, Python 3.0 was released. Okay, this is an history of Python. Why you want to learn Python? Python is a most powerful language, and we can say it is one of the richest programming language. Because going by TOP index, TOP index says that Python is one of the third programming language in the world. What do you mean by TOP? TOP is an indicator of the popularity of programming language. This index is updated every month. So the ratings are based on the number of skilled engineers who are using this programming language, and also third party vendors who are using this language. This ratings, it is based on the search engines like Google, Yahoo, etc. Okay, so we can say that this index is not about the best programming language. It is about the programmers who are using this particular language. Okay, that is why we can say that this Python is one of the richest programming language which is used in worldwide. Coming to the features of Python, the first is simple and easy to learn. So the Python is very simple and easy to learn language when compared with other languages like C, C++. Okay, this is the first feature. The second is free and open source. Python is freely available for everyone. It is freely available in the official website www.python.org. Okay, this is freely available, or otherwise you can search in Google like download Python. You can download this Python, and it is open source. Why it is open source is like this code is freely available in the website, and you can download it and you can also share it and you can do the changes. So it is open source software. And the next one is Python is a portable language. What do you mean by portable is when you write a code in Windows platform and you are going to move the same code to other platforms like Linux, Unix or Macintosh, the same code will work. You need not have to do any changes in your coding. That is why it is called portable. Okay, so you're writing the code in one platform and running the code in other platform is possible in case of Python language. Next is extensible. If needed, you can write your Python code in other languages like C, C++. This makes a Python an extensible language. That means that it is extendable to other languages also. That is why you can say it is an extensible language. So you can write your Python code in C, C++ also. So that is why it is called as extensible language. Next feature is GUI programming. GUI is graphical user interface. Always users wants the software with GUI. That means like it will be very comfortable for them and it will be easily accessible also. That is why every user wants their software with GUI features. So this Python is having wide range of libraries for creating your GUI applications. Okay, if you want to create any application, GUI based applications, you can use the Python for doing that purpose. That is why it is called as GUI programming. Next is object oriented. Python language is an object oriented language. It supports both procedure oriented and object oriented. So there are two types of programming can be done. One is procedure oriented. The next one is object oriented. Okay. So in procedure oriented languages, it was built based on procedures. Okay. Based on procedures, all the programs will be built. Coming to object oriented, here the programs are built with classes and objects. So here the Python is both procedure oriented and object oriented language. That means it supports procedures, functions, classes and objects. Okay, that is why it is called as object oriented. Next comes interpreted. We can say that Python is an interpreted language. What do you mean by interpreted languages? So in case of C, C++, so you cannot run your program directly. You need to compile first and then after compilation, you have to run your program. That is the process in case of C, C++. But in case of Python, you can execute the program directly. That means you can run your program directly. So what happens inside the Python is like where Python software is, there will be an interpreter which does all this. Okay, so actually the source code, the Python code what you're writing, that will be converted into a bytecode internally. Okay, so this bytecode, which then it is converted into a machine code. So this is a process which is taken place inside your interpreter. So the source code, how you are writing your Python, it will be converted into an intermediate code called bytecode. This bytecode, which is converted into a machine code so that the machine can understand this particular codes. This is the process happens in your Python software. What do you mean by interpreted? Interpreted means here always we mean that all your source code, it will be interpreted line by line. That means it will be executed line by line, not at all once. In other languages, what happens is all the source code will be executed at once. But here it will be executed line by line. So the debugging will be very easy and we can able to correct the errors then and there. That is why it is called interpreted language. So this interpreter, it will execute the line by line. It will check for errors line by line. That is why it is called interpreted language. Okay. Next, it says that Python is a high level language. Yes, Python is an high level language because we don't need to remember about the system architecture or we do not have to manage the memory. Everything is done by the software itself. That is why we say that it is a high level language and it is also programmer friendly also and it will execute the programs at a faster rate. That is why it is called as high level language. Next is it supports large standard library. So here the Python has wide range of library routines where it can able to run your write programs for simple text processing to complex games also. So need not have to write code for every single thing. All the routines are available inside your Python software. So you can make use of all those library routines when you are designing your application. So it is having a large standard library routines. The last feature is it is an integrated language. That is, you can easily integrate Python with other languages like C, C++, etc. So it is an integrated language. So here the Python, we have seen 10 features: simple and easy to learn, free and open software. It is easy to learn language. It is freely available and it is open source. It is portable language, extensible. GUI, you can create GUI applications. It is an object oriented one. Interpreter, that means it will be executed line by line, not at all once. It is a high level language. It has wide range of library routines. And last is, it is an integrated language. So that's all about the features of Python. So these are the applications of Python. If you see, the Python applications can be used for variety of applications. Like first, it can be used to develop web-based applications. And it is also used to work with images. So if you have an image and you want to do some enhancement or any other modification, you want to do it in the image, you can do it with the help of Python. And next is scientific and numeric problems. For those cases, scientific and numeric applications also Python is used. And if you want to develop any GUI based applications, then Python software is a very good language for developing those GUI applications. Next, if you want to develop your business, if you want any software needed for your business, you can use Python language for that. And if you want to develop any multimedia applications which includes audio and video, for that also Python can be used. And if you are working in a company and you want to develop your own specialized software, for that Python language is used in your enterprise. So those applications are enterprise applications. And you want to design any games, Python language is a very good language for that. And if you are into teaching and you want to develop any software for teaching purpose, for that also Python language is used. So there are variety of applications where Python is used. Okay, these are the applications of Python. Next comes the advantages of Python over other languages, and we will discuss the disadvantages also. Coming to less coding. So when you are coding with C, C++, you have to write large number of codes. But in case of Python, you require only less number of codes to program. So this is the one biggest advantage of your Python, less coding. Second is affordable. We all know Python is free and it is open source, so where you can download it from the website. So any companies or any programmer, they can download it and they can use the software without buying the license. So it is affordable. Next is extensible support libraries. So Python is having wide range of libraries for everything. So you can use Python for any type of applications. So these are the three biggest advantages of Python when compared with other languages. Coming to the disadvantage, the first one is speed. We all know Python uses interpreter for executing it. So interpreter always execute line by line. So we say that in that case, the speed will be very slow when compared with other languages. So speed is one of the problem. Second is difficulty in using other language. So if you are a Python lover, you will be accustomed with the features and also its extensible libraries. So when you are learning other languages, you face difficulty in learning other languages. That is one of the disadvantages when you are learning this. When you first learn Python, you feel difficult to learn other languages. That is the second disadvantage. And third is, it is weak in mobile computing. That means always a Python, we have seen the presence in only in desktop or server platform. It is weak in mobile computing. We have seen very few applications which runs in mobile application. So that is why it is one of the disadvantage in Python language. So these are the advantages and disadvantages of Python when compared with other languages. Coming to the versions of Python, Python 1.0 was released in the year January 1994 by Guido van Rossum. Since Python is used in every technical field, this Python will be updated regularly with new features and support. So there are a lot of updates are available in Python, started from 1994 to the current. So currently you can see lot of versions has been released in every year, and currently we are using the Python 3.9 version, which was released in recently in 2020. Okay. When you are learning Python, you should make sure that why you want to learn Python. There are number of applications where general areas where Python is used. Suppose you can use the Python for data analytics or artificial intelligence or games, or you want to develop any desktop application. So pick any one area among this and you can start your journey in learning Python based on that particular application. Second is, you should learn the basic syntax. If you learn the basic syntax, then it will be easier for you to dive into the deep learning. Okay, that is the second thing. And third is, write your coding by your own. So if any simple coding is given for you, you can write by yourself. Next is, you should keep practicing. So after you learn the basic syntax, you should try to write some simple codes. Okay, and you should make a note of it. So these are the tips for learning your Python. Now we will see how we will install the Python in your system. In order to become a Python developer, first you need to install Python in your system. So for that, you should go to this website www.python.org/download, and you can download the recent release of Python in your system. After that, try to install that Python, that version into your system by clicking on it. Okay, this is how you can install your Python in your system. Now we will see what is Python interpreter and interactive mode. So there are two modes of programming. One is interactive mode programming. Next one is script mode programming. Coming to interactive mode programming, so it is a command line shell. That is, like, it will be a command line shell where you can give your problem and it will be the interpreter will give you the result immediately. It's just like a calculator. Suppose I want to calculate 5 plus 6. So when you give this in the command prompt, it will give you the result immediately. So it is interactive. This is one type of programming. This is called interactive mode programming. So it is a command line shell which gives immediate feedback for every statement. So for any statement you give, it will give you the immediate feedback. So this is interactive mode programming. So you can work in this mode, or otherwise you can go for script mode programming. So in script mode programming, you have to store your data in a file or a script. Okay, you can call it as a script or you can call it as a file. You'll be storing your data into a file, and what you'll do is you'll execute that particular script. So while you are storing your data, you'll be storing it in .py extension. So like in a Word extension, okay, when you are writing your Word file, you'll be storing it in .doc, right? Likewise, so here you are writing a code and afterwards you have to store it in .py extension. So when you execute this program, this code, .py code, you will get your result in your command prompt. Command prompt will give you the result. So what is the difference between interactive mode and script mode is, in interactive mode you can execute only one line by, that is one statement at a time. But here in script mode programming, number of statements can be combined and it can be stored into a single file, and you can execute the file, and whenever you want you can able to retrieve the file and you can run the program. But here it is not possible. Once you have given here, the statements will be lost. Okay, once if you close that particular shell. But here the file which has been stored in your desktop, it will be forever. And if you want, you can run your script whenever it is possible. So it is script mode programming. So there are two types of programming. One is interactive mode programming and script mode programming. Okay, I think you all have enjoyed this video. So in today's video, we have learned on the overview of Python, the history of Python, and then we have learned the features of Python and applications, advantages and disadvantages. Lastly, we have seen the versions of Python. At last, we have seen the Python installation, and we have also discussed on the interactive mode and script mode programming. Thank you for watching. Thank you all.